Mammoth Hot Springs Hotel area. Beware of the lawn ornaments. These elk are not made of plastic, but 1,000 pounds of live muscle, hooves, and antlers. In the late fall, the lawns of Mammoth are one of the last sources of green vegetation, which attracts elk from all around. Fall is also the elk mating season, which makes them especially aggressive and dangerous. Across the street from the Albright Visitor Center is the sagebrush meadow that was the parade ground upon which U.S. cavalry troops practiced maneuvers. National Hotel guests routinely gathered on the porch to watch the cavalry conduct these mounted drills. In addition to the usual flanking maneuvers and charges, trick riding and jumping became part of the show. More than practice and entertainment, these demonstrations were a show of force, a reminder that the military was taking their unusual assignment as seriously as if they were guarding Fort Knox. The north wing of Yellowstone's first lodge, the stately National Hotel, built in 1883, is now the core of Mammoth Hot Springs Hotel. In a room off the Mammoth lobby hangs a huge map of the United States made from 16 types of wood from 9 countries. It was designed by Robert Reamer, who is most famous for the Old Faithful Inn architecture. Robert Reamer also worked with Captain Hiram H. Chittenden of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to design the Roosevelt Arch with its timeless inscription, "For the benefit and enjoyment of the people." No person understood the value of Yellowstone better than President Theodore Roosevelt. In 1903, after laying the cornerstone for the Roosevelt Arch at the Northern Park entrance near Gardiner, Montana, he simultaneously congratulated and admonished the 4,000 people assembled and the subsequent millions who, while passing underneath, would ponder the arch's inscription. Speaking to them, speaking to us, Roosevelt said, "I cannot too often repeat that the essential feature of the present management of the Yellowstone Park, as in all similar places, is its essential democracy. It is the preservation of the scenery, of the forests, of the wilderness life and wilderness game, for the people as a whole."